think it'll work. It'll work fine. You'll get all the rollover that you you can handle, and we're going to do a thermal conversion near the end of it, which means we're going to open up a fog nozzle, so you're going to get to see what it's like to do something along those lines inside that environment. And you'll see, like I said, plenty of rollover. You'll see the penciling technique, how well it works, how well it operates when you're inside. So that's a little bit about today. For our guests, how did you find out about this class? Rob Boyer. Okay. Guys at work?
Training chief.
Chief?
Guys at work.
All right, we got a Facebook page too, so we're just trying to find out if that's working at all. The truth unfolds. You guys are looking at that. Flashover. You're not going to experience flashover today. You're going to experience flashover today. Everything in that box would burst into flames. That's you included. We're going to go over some temperatures later on in the class about when Nomex breaks down, when their Lexan shield breaks down, when your skin's going to break down. We want to know what the signs are of this, how we're going to recognize a flashover. What are the parameters involved around it? How's it going to get started? As we pull up on the scene, what are we looking for? Out of the building, out of the box that we're going to go into here in a little bit. And then how are we going to survive this event, if it is there? What we're trying to do today, we have a safe and secure system for flashover training. You're going to be about 4 feet below the actual fire today. We put 5 sheets of half-inch MDF inside the box. We ignite it with a little bit of hay. It gets going. It'll go through the incipient to growth, the fully developed stages. We have 2 vents in the can. You'll see one vent we keep open behind you in the observation module. The other vent, the event instructor is going to play. As meeting, he's going to open that up whenever you hit it with the nozzle to get some of that steam out there and clear it out. You're going to see a very clear demarcation line with the thermal barriers that we talked about later on. We'll talk about temperatures inside the can and where we're going with that. Along with the carbon monoxide, the temperature at which it ignites, and the tongues of flames, and the mixture that it takes to go ahead and ignite those tongues of flames, meaning the oxygen content and the upper limits of the carbon monoxide. We want to know what the signs are, what the flashover is, how it develops, and what we can do to prevent. And those techniques that we're talking about are the penciling techniques. Just be advised, these penciling techniques are just that. They're a method to cool down that atmosphere at the top of the box that we're going into. That's all it is. It's not a firefighting technique. It's an evaluation technique. Technique that we cool down that upper atmosphere and not destroy that thermal balance that we have inside that box. And now it's time to get out. So I can see. If I force the door, I change the vent profile in the box already as soon as I open up the door. I introduce more oxygen into that environment. Once I do that, the technique is I want to take that nozzle and give it a couple shots in the overhead. If I got water coming back down on me, it's not at that boiling point of water. That water didn't vaporize and turn into steam. If that's the case, if I have excessive oppressive heat pushing me to the ground, I see thick black pumping smoke out of this building as I'm rolling up on it, and I get that when I come in there, I need to open this place up a little bit more than I've done already before I send some crews in there with a hose line. Okay. So those are the things that we're talking about. And obviously we want to save you from injury or death from flashover. Hydration is critical. Okay, we want to make sure, I know the class, we've talked about not to be too crude, but they need to be pissing clear by today. Right? I want to make sure they're fully hydrated. And during this entire class, you saw what their PT is like around here. We do that twice a week, so they need to stay hydrated, especially when you're in your gear. You know already, guys that are in service, that it's a whole different animal when you're out there working in the gear, other than in your PT clothes or just your normal uniform out there on the street doing some kind of work. It's a whole other thing. You have the gear restriction, you have your muscles working against the movement inside the turnout gear itself, and your body doesn't cool down as much, so you need to stay hydrated, even when you're working on the street or for anything you're trying to do in a class like this. We know what some of the signs of dehydration are. Small, minor tasks, manipulative tasks, tie knots, even manipulate their air pack, tighten their mask, things like that. They get a glazed look in their eye and they just start to go. So those are things that we look for. Drinking schedule is, as I said earlier, and we're not going to go ahead. Full protective clothing, when we're talking about flashover, what we deal with full protective clothing. That means everything that the manufacturer has put on the gear we're going to utilize. Every snap, every hook, every zipper, every Velcro closure, everything. I don't want to see any skin exposed, and you don't want to see any skin exposed when you're out there. We're going to have the safety officer that's going to check you. We're going to do buddy checks on each other and make sure we have a full air supply. I'd like to see a good air check on your remote gauge before you go in there. Remember, anytime we're entering an IDLH, we want to do an air check. We talk about air management. We'll get into that a little later. Backdraft. Backdraft is an environment whereas the oxygen is depleted from that high heat, plenty of fuel ready to ignite, but the oxygen's gone at that point. We open it up, we force it, we ventilate a window, and now we introduced into the air into that environment, which is primed for an explosion at that point. And then rollover. Rollover is what you're actually going to be viewing and seeing today. When we talk about our flashover and our burn module over there, you're going to see those tongues of flames inside the smoke. You're going to see it roll over from the actual burn module over your heads to go to the rear vent where it's looking for oxygen. So you're going to see that roll over. The same thing you would see as you're crawling down a hallway. You got a room of contents in the back bedroom. This thing's going off pretty good in there. You force the door, you're working your way in through the smoke, and you see the rollover coming down that hallway. We talk about an indirect attack to cool things down. Then we talk about a combination attack as we get closer and a direct attack as we get in. Now, we have that thick, black, pumping smoke inside the structure, oppressive heat pushing us to the ground. I know in the standards classes, you know, we're doing our engine evolutions and we tell them, get down, stay low, it's hot in here. But we're telling them that. Now, when you're actually experiencing this, you have no choice. You want to hug the ground. Right? Everything gets very hot very quickly and you want to get on the ground. When you go into that type of environment, you want to do your penciling technique, you get an evaluation of what's in the overhead, what kind of gases or heat you've got in that temperature range in that area, and then make the determination to change your incident action plan that you possibly aren't doing the right thing at this point. Okay? Pushing in on something like this could be a recipe for disaster because this thing's ripe for a flash if you go at any time. We'll talk more about that later. Backdraft. Definition of explosion or rapid burning of heated gases that occur when oxygen is introduced into an oxygen deficient atmosphere. And we see that very infrequently with actual backdraft. A lot of times these places are going to self-ventilate. There was a video that came out of New Jersey, I think it was a few months ago. I don't know if anybody's seen that on YouTube, but it was pretty close to what they were calling a backdraft. I looked at it, it looked, I don't know, the place was opened up from what I could see. I don't know, has anybody seen it? Anybody evaluated or looked at it? Yeah. What was your impression on it?
Like you said, it was already venting.
Yeah, it was opened up.
I'm thinking maybe there was contents in there that...
Right, or a possible smoke explosion or even gas. Yeah, so. But anyway, they're kind of rare, unless you watch that movie. It happens over and over. You guys see that yet? How many saw it? Raise your hand. You got a deficient, I told you. Ladder 49 in backdraft are required to make this class. So you better get on it, right? We're going to reference some of that stuff. All right, a flashover usually catches us off guard, and that's what we don't want to tolerate anymore in the business. Right? Develops rapidly with little warning. It increases our firefighting problems because at this point, we've got chased from the structure if we're not having issues or problems in there. And anybody inside is not going to be able to survive that event. Flashover is the entire ignition of all the contents inside that box that's on fire. Why do we see more protection for flashover now? Our PPE. When I came into the business in 81, they didn't even issue a flashover. We didn't get them. Had to pull our air flaps down. So there was always just kind of a little bit of space opened up. So we wouldn't get in there. You couldn't go in there. Your ears would get singed, blister, and everything. And okay, time to back out. Let's get out of here. We got to do something different. Can't make it that far. I relate a story of our last structure burn that we just had. We just got new instructor gear done. instructor gear means I bumped up the linings in the shoulder area, in the front of the legs, because we see a lot of heat down there as instructors. Well, the instructor was in there and he was loading the burn. He was putting pallets on the fire in between sets. We run our students in there on the attack, on the nozzle, we back them out. They do a rotation and the next ones come up. So we want to keep the fire going so everybody gets that experience as they're making an attack on the fire. We should go get the gear, the flash hood and everything, of the flaps from the hood, or flaps from the helmet. And that's all due to the excessive heat that he was feeling in there. But he wasn't feeling it, which was part of the problem. Underneath here was the flash hood, and then the extra padding and the extra thermal protection that he had on the gear. I'm going to let this sit up here. You guys can look at it if you want. You don't need to pass this around. It's still got some carbon on it, I'm sure. So, I don't mess with that too much. But then the compostable contents that we deal with. All right. Our instant definition of a flashover. Flames flash over the entire surface of a room or area.
Even during an emergency, don't jump out and exit the fire truck. Let us know what's going on.
They were with me.
Alright. Just a brief description of the flashover can and how it's going to operate and what we're going to do inside of the procedures, alright? This is our burn room that's in here. All we have is marble boards on the walls and that can inside there. Basically, we're going to light that can off. Just get to heat up that particle board. That particle board is going to off gas. Those gases and everything else, and that smoke is going to start to travel. It's going to want to find its path of least resistance, which is this vent and the back vent. So it's going to start flowing that way. Pretty soon what you're going to start to see is little fingers of fire go over there, and then we're going to have rollover. Okay, so you'll have fire from, almost front to back of this can. You'll be able to experience that. Those are those precursor signs. If you're crawling down a hallway, you start seeing those fingers overhead, high heat, turbulent smoke, everything else. That's that precursor sign letting us know that, hey, something's going on in that room, it's probably ready to flash. So we need to start cooling that environment or maybe find a different, a different approach on this. So, again, we'll light this off. You'll have your smoke coming out. You'll have all your hot gases and everything. They reach that ignition temperature. They're going to start to roll out of here, little fingers, and then you're going to have rollover overhead. These doors right here will be up, which you'll notice inside this room.
Safety from command.
What's in there is what's in there.
Safety, guys.
What's in there is what's in there.
I'm advised when the talk is over with and then the students are ready to go. Affirming.
You're going to see this pretty much floor ceiling fire. All right? Now, we're in a lower position down here. That's how we can witness this. That's how we can view this phenomenon flashover without getting burned ourselves. Now, you're going to be in this low position down here, okay? You're going to have the nozzle. You locate it right where it is, and it matters a little bit. And trust me, by the time you get done burning, you're gonna be back a lot further. That nozzle is gonna be in position there. First thing you're gonna do when you get the nozzle is you're gonna grab it, and you're gonna make sure that it's set for a straight stream. Okay, turn all the way to the right. If you turn all the way to the left and it's a fog, bad things happen. So, straight stream. You'll have it in a ready position. Okay, you don't have to have your hands way up high or anything else, because that's where the heat is, right? So keep it in a ready position, and we're gonna pencil the ceiling. Start the door, so you can go over and have a pencil outside. Basically, this is where we pencil, this area right up here. The instructor will direct you to pencil. They'll tell you to hit it, left, right, center, whatever they do. And you'll give it two quick short bursts, okay? We don't want to put water inside the can itself. If you put water inside there, we blacken the fire down too much, and pretty much you're going to sit in here and bathe, and you're going to just watch smoke build until the actual fire starts up again. So we keep the water out of there, all right? And we pencil up here. Now, once we pencil and the instructor tells you to rotate, okay? You don't do anything until the instructor tells you to do anything. So once the instructor says rotate, basically you're going to drop off from where you are and go behind Henry. You're going to drop off and go behind that white back there and drop off behind White. So you go first, stay low, rotate,
Stay low. Stay low.
All right, and you're going to move forward. So this is how the rotation would go. Now you have the nozzle, and what do you do first? Exactly. And then we're in that ready position, right? At a certain point in time, this thing's going to start going quickly, all right? So the rotations might happen very quickly. You have to pay attention to that. Remember, well over 1,000 degrees in the pan in front of us, okay? Temperatures overhead can be 600-700 degrees. Down here, 300 degrees. You're going to absorb a lot of heat. There's nowhere for that heat to go. It's in a can. You're going to start to absorb it. You're going to want to fluff your gear. You're going to want to move. You're going to want to change knees, change positions. Don't stare into the fire too long. That radiant heat will bake on your mask. It'll melt your mask, okay? If you start to experience anything where you're too hot, you're having a gear malfunction, any problems whatsoever, you have to let us know. The only communication in here are us talking to you and you telling us if something's wrong, all right? So if anything starts to bother you, or you get too hot, whatever else, hey, we'll rotate you to the back of the can, cool you off, whatever we can. If you can't fix it there, out before you go, we'll send you out. Right, you can change the rotation. So, if you're experiencing any problems, you gotta let us know. There's, you know, there's no way to control the temperature inside here. You open that vent, it's only gonna vent off so much. And we're gonna start to absorb that. My gear, my tolerance is a lot different than yours for being inside here, okay? So, you know, if you're gonna get hot, don't just go, I got hot. No, you're gonna, that's gonna happen, all right? But there's no way that you can move to. So, down low, right, we're going to go ahead and pencil it, and now you're going to rotate. So, once he moves, you move. Okay? Okay, first thing you do? Exactly. Now we pencil it, we hit it left, we hit it. Very fast. Let's play with the dark. We're going to be after this.
Hey guys, see what happened with that smoke? We put water on it. Okay, and this is the kind of stuff we want you to look at. Look how it's more pressured at this end where the fire is. Taylor, what you getting ready to do?
Thank you.
Instructional Station, please.